Hi, I'm Gatri, product marketer at Sharetribe, and in this video, we're setting up a membership fee for our marketplace. Membership fee, also known as subscription fee, is a marketplace revenue model where some or all of the marketplace's users are charged a recurring fee to access the platform, for example, on a monthly or yearly basis. This tutorial is for a blanket membership fee, meaning that it's charged from all users, but you could also have a subscription system where you charge a fee for posting rights or for the right to start transactions with customers. For this tutorial, you'll need the following things: a Sharetribe account, a Zapier account, and a Stripe account, or an account with another payment system that enables subscription payments, creating a payment page with your own content and branding, and is a Zapier app if you want to automate your subscription flow. And you can find relevant links to all of these things below. The steps of this tutorial are: set up a Stripe subscription page, turn on user approval in your Sharetribe console, update marketplace text related to subscriptions, create a test user to test subscriptions, and set up a Zap to automate user approval. And a heads up before we get started. In this tutorial, we are creating a test flow on your test marketplace in Sharetribe and using test Stripe data. Testing is a vital step in creating new user flows as it lets us try how things work and that they work correctly before making them live to actual users. When you're ready to make your subscription flow live, you'll need a Sharetribe Pro or Extend plan as live Zapier integrations are limited to those plans. But you can test all of this on the build plan or even during the free trial. All set? Let's do this. We'll start with setting up a Stripe payment page, or in our case, a subscription page. If at the time you're watching this, Stripe's dashboard looks different from this video, you can find more up-to-date information and images in Sharetribe's Help Center, but the basics are the same regardless. To start accepting payments through Stripe, you'll need to activate your account. You can find instructions for this in Sharetribe's Help Center. Once you have your Stripe dashboard and an activated account, check that you're working with test data. You can find the test and live data toggle at the top of the dashboard. Then, navigate to Product Catalog in the sidebar navigation. This is where you create your subscription product. So, click the button to add a new product. In the form that opens, fill in a name for your membership subscription and add a description of what it's about. In our case, these would be BikeTribe membership, and this is a monthly membership to the BikeTribe platform. You can also add an optional image to your product, but I'll skip that. Below, you'll find the details about payment. First, choose if the payments are recurring or one-off. Since we're setting up subscriptions, we'll choose recurring. Then, fill in the amount for a single subscription payment and choose the currency. In my case, that'll be 9.90 and euros. Next, you decide what the billing period will be. Stripe offers a lot of options: daily, weekly, monthly, yearly, but we'll choose monthly, which is often the standard for subscriptions. But of course, you should choose what fits your platform best. Finally, click Add Product. You now have a membership product ready in Stripe. The next step is to navigate to Payments and Payment Links in the sidebar. On the page, click Create Test Payment Link. Here, you'll create the subscription payment page for your memberships. First, choose the product you just created in the product catalog. After that, there are a lot of options Stripe offers that you can add to your payment page, which I recommend taking a good look at. There's also a tab for after payment, where you can choose if you want to use the default Stripe message after someone subscribes, or create your own custom message. On the right side, you can see a preview of what your payment page will look like. Once your payment page is configured, click Create Link in the top right corner. And then the final thing you need to do in your Stripe dashboard is to copy the link to this payment page. Now it's time to jump over to your Sharetribe console. Navigate to Access Control Settings, which you can find in the Build section under General. There, enable two features: Make Marketplace Private and Approve Users Who Want to Join. Making your marketplace private means users need to log in to access listings. User approval means that new users need operator approval before they can take actions like starting transactions on the marketplace. When you enable user approval, you'll see three options below: No Call to Action, internal link, or external link. What you choose here determines whether you want your users to take a specific action to get approval. For example, if you want to just review each user manually, you can choose no call to action. However, we want new users to subscribe, so we'll choose external link. I'll add the text link subscribe and then paste the URL copied from our Stripe dashboard into the external link address field. We'll also add dynamic URL parameters, which are crucial for automating subscriptions through Zapier. These parameters allow Zapier to fetch the user's ID and email from Stripe, enabling subscription automation. So we'll add a user ID parameter and a user email parameter. And you don't need to remember this off the top of your head. You can copy the exact parameters from Sharetribe's Help Center or the description of this video. Then, save changes. Now, when someone joins your platform and tries to start a transaction without being approved, they'll get this call to action button with a message letting them know they're pending approval. The default text on the page is a bit generic though, which brings us to the next step in our tutorial, updating marketplace texts. We'll make changes to the title and content of this information box to direct users to subscribe if they want to get approved. So navigate to Content and Marketplace Texts. There, click your cursor to the Marketplace Text Editor box and search for NoAccessPage.userPendingApproval, and you'll find three different strings of text. These are the ones we'll be editing now. The heading will be Subscribe to Bytribe to get access. The schema title will be Subscribe to Bytribe. This is the text you see in browser tabs for this page. And then finally, I'll update the content to refer to the subscription and the price specifically. Now our marketplace text also makes sense within the context of our subscriptions. And remember to save changes. Okay, most of our subscription flow is now ready. Go to your test marketplace and create a new test user to see how the flow works for them. The easiest way to get there is by clicking the View Marketplace link in your console top bar. Click to sign up and fill in the necessary details like email, first name, last name, and password, and any other user fields you may have added. Then accept the terms and privacy policy and sign up. Now, this user has access to listings in your marketplace since they now have an account. However, if they try to start a transaction, which in my example platform means making a booking to rent a bike, they will be shown the page we just edited. Click to subscribe. On the payment page, you can see the URL parameters we added in action. In the URL, you can see the user's ID and their email. You can also see the email already pre-filled in the payment form, which makes for a smoother user experience. Fill in test card information and a cardholder name to start a subscription, and then click Pay and Subscribe. Stripe has now collected the payment. If you navigate back to Console and go to your Manage Users tab, you'll find the new user there. So now you have a subscribed user pending approval. Basically, you could have a membership system just with these features we've configured so far and manually approve anyone who subscribes in the Manage tab. But this tutorial is about automating membership fees. This brings us to the final step in this tutorial. It's time to move over to Zapier. Zapier is a great tool that lets you automate tons of different kinds of tasks on your marketplace. One of the great things about Zapier is that you can use it to connect over 5,000 apps, Sharetribe being one of them, with each other. Zapier is connected to Sharetribe through Sharetribe's integration API. This means that the first thing you'll need to do in this section is to generate an integration API key, which happens in the advanced settings in your console. Open the Applications tab and click to add a new application. Give the application a name. In our case, Zapier is a good choice. Choose the API, integration API, and finally, click Add Application. At this point, you're presented with a client ID and client secret for Zapier. Save the client ID and secret somewhere secure, such as a password manager. This is the only time you'll see the client secret for this app, so make sure you have it saved. But if you still end up losing it, you can always add a new application here in console. At this point, it's also good to remind you that once you go live, you'll need to generate a live integration API key, which is limited to the Pro and Extend plans of Sharetribe. Once you've copied and saved the secret, click I've copied the secret. Now, we move on to Zapier. Our next task is creating the Zap that will automate our listing fees. Zap is a word for Zapier automation. So at this point, you'll need to have your Zapier account ready to go. Okay, we have a couple of ways to get started. You can either create this Zap from scratch or use a template created by Sharetribe's customer advocacy team. Using a template can get you started with Zapier faster than creating Zaps from scratch, but we're creating a relatively simple Zap in this video, so we'll go through the process from a blank slate. So in your Zapier account, click to create a new Zap. This will take you to a page that looks something like this. Click on the first step or trigger box and search for the app you want to start with. In our case, this is Stripe. When you pick Stripe in the app selection, it opens a box on the right side where we'll set up and test the trigger. The trigger event we want to use for this automation is checkout session completed, i.e. somebody has made a successful payment in Stripe. At this point, you need to connect your Stripe account. I've already connected mine, but in a nutshell, this means getting test API keys from Stripe, which you can find in the developer section of your test mode Stripe dashboard. Once you've connected your Stripe account, click to continue. The next step is configure. Choose true as the answer to the question about using test data and click continue again. The final step is test trigger. This step finds checkout session information from your Stripe account. So click to test the trigger. Zapier found three different checkout sessions in my Stripe account. I choose checkout A, and if I scroll down to the details, I can see that it's a payment of $9.90, and the description matches the subscription product I created too. Click to continue with the selected record. Now, we move on to the next step of this Zap. This is an action that's triggered by step one, the trigger. The first thing we need to do is choose the app we want to use in the action, which is Sharetribe. And again, we need to set up and configure this action. In the setup step, choose the action Approve User. Then, connect your Sharetribe account to your Zapier account. This is where you will need the integration API client ID and secret you saved earlier. Once you've connected your Sharetribe account, click to continue. In the configure step, click on the plus sign in the user ID field and search for client reference ID in the selection that opens. The client reference ID here is the ID of the user who's pending approval. We sent this ID to Stripe through the dynamic parameters we added to the payment page URL. Choose true in the next field, expand the response to return the full resource, and click to continue. Then, just like we did with the trigger, we need to test. So click test step. Zapier successfully found the user who was pending approval. Now, if we check our Sharetribe console and update the manage users page, we can see that the user has been approved. This happened automatically through the Zap we just created. Since the Zap is working as intended, the next thing to do is to click Publish. And at this point, if you haven't yet, remember to give your Zap a name to keep track of what it does. I almost forgot about that. This is the bare minimum Zap flow you'll need to automate memberships, but you can build much longer workflows with Zapier. For example, you could add steps like sending an email to the user when they've been approved or to yourself as the marketplace owner when a new user has joined and paid a subscription, or add many other tasks to your subscription automation workflow. As I mentioned in the beginning of the video, this setup happened in your test environment with test data. When you're ready to make your subscription flow live, follow the same steps as in this tutorial, but in your live marketplace and Stripe dashboard instead. So that's setting automated membership subscriptions in your Sharetribe marketplace. In this tutorial, we went through the three key stages of setting up subscription payments: creating a Stripe subscription page, configuring access control settings, and setting up a Zap to automate user approval when someone subscribes. Your marketplace is now monetized through membership subscriptions. I hope this video helps you set up subscriptions in your marketplace, and best of luck with your business.